Stay tuned for the Best of the Filmmakers Show next, right here on Cablevision Channel 20.
Hi, Jerry Parisi here for the Long Island Filmmakers Show. We have a very special episode tonight. It's with John Pallotta and the John Pallotta School of Acting. John has been an award winner for many, many years straight, and John has run incredible acting classes from New York to D.C. to several other states. And John, tell me about some of the states you're in. Let's start right up. How many places you actually do teach?
Well, besides here, I teach at several places in New York. I'm in Washington, D.C., Virginia, Chicago, Boston. I Skype weekly, international. I'm supposed to teach in India. That's in the works. I was supposed to teach in Moscow, L.A. on several occasions. But I have regular studios in Washington, New York, Virginia, Boston, and Chicago.
I have to say that's more than I've ever heard of any other teacher. Not that I know so many as well as I know you, but you've been doing this for many, many years. And how many years?
Well, back in, it had to be 76, 75, after, I forgot the name of the movie. My friends and I were in Hell's Kitchen back in 76, 77, and we saw on 10th Avenue, we saw Al Pacino walking down 10th Avenue, and my friends and I just, we came from Queens, from Howard Beach, where I was born. And we just watched Al Pacino and followed him. And we followed him into what we thought was a church. And we ran up the balcony and we hid behind, and we're like, where Al Pacino goes to church? And we soon realized that this was a place called the Irish Studio. And it was a church. So, and then this woman comes behind me. Later on, Anna Strasberg, wanting to know what we're doing there. so that's how I got into acting, and never looked back.
Tell me, John, where are some of the acting schools that you went to start with?
I go back to Lee Strasberg, Stella Adler.
Oh, Stella Adler.
HB Studio, Stella Adler herself. I studied with all the masters, pretty much all the masters, except Sandy Meisner. I didn't like the name. I thought it was Sissy. But I studied with all of them. Probably the ones that I liked the best were William Hickey, who was noted for Prince's Honor, Academy Award nominee for Prince's Honor, and also Bobby Lewis. Bobby Lewis and I pretty much learned the most. My technique, acting as a state of mind, is pretty much based a lot on Bobby Lewis. Bobby Lewis is probably the least known, but he's one of my most favorite.
And John, I have a question for you, for the audience as well. You have trained incredibly big names.
Yeah.
And just to set you apart from different schools, just can you name some of those names?
Coach people, Josh Charles, dialogue with Josh Charles, Johnny Alonzo, Mia Michaels has been to my studio. There's people have endorsed me, but that I didn't necessarily coach.
I think Meryl Streep endorsed you.
I just said kind words to my students, but I didn't necessarily, it's not an endorsement. Kevin Kline gave nice words. Who else going down the list? It's a lot of people.
That's
Danny Aiello. Seth Meyers, I'm just going down the list.
And it's truly a long list from
Kate
what I know.
Kate Pearson, Roger Mason, New York Knicks, Kyle Lowry, Nita Heat. It goes down the list.
Goes down the list. Now, from what I saw in tonight's class, you have a very different technique mm-hmm. than most acting teachers. And while I've not been to every single acting school in New York City, I obviously loved your working with you way back when I did. And some of the important things that you did, comes across in your technique. So we've got some scenes that we'll watch in a little while, but tell me, that technique, how did you develop it?
You know, the thing is, I studied with all these people, and the more and more I studied acting, I realized it's not about acting, it's about the depths of your humanity, how far you're willing to go. And, you know, in the later years of the people I studied with, and all the you gotta realize, and I don't mean this bad about any acting school, is the acting, the school system is meant to keep you there. You know, Meisner 1, Acting 1, Acting 2, Acting 3, Acting 4, Acting 5, to keep you in that system. So they develop a curriculum to keep you there. You know, these days, these students haven't got 6 years to be in an acting school. They want to be working. And there are accelerated methods to get you along through the process and get you out there working faster. And my technique, I think, gets you in touch with who you are quicker, faster. So, and learning what to do in front of instruments like that cinematically faster. And I think that that's what we try to accomplish. Sadly, there's people out there that don't think they need training. A lot of people have talent, but there's talent and then there's skill. Skill is another thing. You know, getting up there and knowing what you're doing, your use of back and knowing how to do it cinematically with your back. Everybody has talent, but then there's skill, you know, and then there's mastering the craft. But, you know, as much as I know, I still find myself going to acting classes wherever I go, in D.C., in Chicago, in Boston, because you can never stop learning enough, I think.
So, we're going to go to a couple of clips now. Watch and see how John actually handles some of the techniques. We'll be right back after these clips.
Yes, sir. Damian Merkelich, and I can tell you, John is the best teacher I've seen so far, and I've been with John for 4 years.
Gordon, I've known John Pallotta for 29 years, and I can tell you that he is, without a doubt, the greatest teacher that there is in this country today. What he does, no one else can do.
My name is Bill Rapp, and about a decade ago, when I first got the bug to become an actor and a performer, I was introduced to John. John is my first acting teacher, and I wouldn't still be in the profession if it wasn't for John. He was introduced to me as an actor and playwright who was starting acting classes back then.
And I've had pretty much two lives. I had my former life and now this, where I'm acting. And every decision I made, everything that happened to me led to this point, to me being an actor and training with the best teacher we have. So I need, and I'm taking the next step. So that's why I'm here, to take the next step in acting. Or if you have a scene where it's like, it's good.
I have smoke gets in your eye.
Looks like a piece from House of Cards. Be good for me.
Okay, I took one from Shonda Rhimes' pilot.
I have Orange is the New Black.
Any special character you're going with?
Right now I'm looking at the role as the gay porn star.
Hi, my name is Alexandra. I've never had class with John before yet, and I've been so excited to get the chance to meet him and take class with him and try to deepen the work and find that place of truth that's really enriching.
Sightline, this is all that matters. See this, the C?
Yeah.
This is the fine line between him, the guy you're talking to,
yeah,
and the camera. You can look at him, but I'm going to work on what's called the eye line, right there. This right here. That's that deja vu area. Okay. You walk in, there is that intimate place. You ever see Leonardo DiCaprio in Titanic?
Yeah.
He didn't blink as he was dying, as he was floating away on that woods. He is so focused. A lot of actors fail at the close-up. He's right there, but the camera's here. But you're thinking there. Jeff, dry hump her. That's what's the images that's in your head. All you think about was the life you were going to spend with your character, the kids you were going to bring in. Let's elevate it into the future. Let's say you were married, you had a house in Connecticut, white picket fence. It was a beautiful life. Two cars, two beautiful cars, everything. You come home on the bed and the house you created together. The mattress, you just whatever. And there they are. That's the thing you have to bring to the table. That's the pointers they don't give you.
Sorry.
That's the stuff teachers give you. On stage, in the audition room, there's the multiple internal monologues, that stuff, that drive the external monologue out. Your character, your stimuli, is of course the stage, but in here. The computer's over here. But you know what, at the end of the day, you gotta deliver. That's all that matters is what I told you, in your head. Ready?
I don't understand my feelings anymore. I really don't. I don't understand how I can hate you so much after so much time.
Be truthful in the moment. You've got to be able to do that every day on stage to make it look fresh and new every day.
I don't understand my feelings! I really don't! I don't understand how I can hate you so much after so much time! No matter how much I'd like to not hate you, I hate you even more! I can't even see you anymore!
This is the man you were going to spend the rest of your life with. You go after him.
Go after him!
I don't even understand my feelings anymore. I really don't. I don't understand how I can hate you so much after so much time.
The kids you don't even have yet.
I don't know how much I'd like to not hate you. I hate you even more. It grows. I can't even see you now. All I see is a picture of you. You and her. I don't even know if the picture's real anymore. I don't even care. It's a made-up picture. It invades my head.
Some piece of work. First of all, to do what you did with that young lady as she was sitting there basically was brilliant. You put in front of her a couple. You actually had the couple holding each other, and that piece of acting was coming because she was able to watch that. How and why do you come up with something like that to do?
You know, the thing is, a lot of times I've seen actors, they're bringing nothing to the table. A lot of times when they're in front of a casting director, often I ask the casting director, you know, what they thought about the actor. And sometimes the casting director says, I didn't believe they were talking to anybody. I didn't see anybody in front of them. I didn't believe they were actually talking to anybody. You know, the thing is, I have to create that person, that real situation in front of them. So when they are, you know, in the classroom, we work on it on a conscious level by putting the people in front of them. So when they're out there in the field, in the audition room, on set, on the stage, it's on a subconscious level, but they still see that person. So the thing is, when they're in front of the casting director, at least at the audition, can say, I believe that she was seeing someone. I honestly believe that they saw them two together, that they saw someone together. You know, but then there's other things I do, because not just see that person, that man, but often in a relationship where someone's cheating, they often wonder, who is the other woman? Does that make sense?
Oh, absolutely does.
So making it multi-dimensional, because a lot of times they think, you cheated on me, but who is she? Who is the other woman? So adding a dimension there. You know, the thing is, the actor alone without another person makes it one dimension. Putting the man there makes it two dimension. Adding a third person makes it multi-dimensional. So I try to create acting that's not only layered, that is multi-dimensional, seeing multiple people there. So the thing is, with character work, and I specialize in character development, not just seeing your character, but character's relationship to the surrounding characters around them. So.
KJ Thompson, I've known John for about a month now, and I could already tell that my acting has improved greatly. I'm explaining the rape of my mother.
Okay. And who are you explaining it to?
The other guy in the band.
What year is this?
1960s, 1950s. Segregation. I'm being told I can't sit in front of a bus. There's like whites only, colored only.
And you're pounded. Chances are rocks were thrown at you. You get on the bus, you were told to get to the back of the bus. You were told when you went to a fountain, and there were two fountains there, one said white, one said black, and you wanted to go drink out of the white fountain. Someone said what?
It was coming out planting time. My daddy had to go get seed fertilizer.
Yeah. Okay.
My dad had to go get some seed and fertilizer. Called me, he said, Levy, you're the man in the house now. Take care of your mama while I'm gone. I wasn't but a little boy, about 8 years old.
Push
it. The men come in my mama's house and take hold of her like you take hold of me, you'll make it do what you want. I didn't know what they was doing to her, but I figured whatever it was, it may as well do to me too.
Push her. Push. Push him. Push him!
My daddy had a knife that he kept for hunting. My damnedest to cut one of them's throat. Hit him across the shoulder with it. And he reached back, whacked me across the chest with it. That's what made them stop. But they were scared I was going to bleed to death. And my daddy came home like he done accepted the facts of what happened.
Reality is, this is what your great-great-great-grandmother dealt with, or your grandmother dealt with for that time.
He done come back and accept the facts of what happened. Sold our land to one of them white men, smiled right in his face and sold him our land.
How do you feel about that acting?
It's another day at the office. Because on a set, that's what you gotta bring. If you don't, I can name 20,000 actors that can bring that. It's gotta be real as death. Nice job. Forget it all and go home.
Of course.
You know, reality is, there's actors that do this every day. And then they right before that, they're doing the crossword puzzle.
Hi, my name is Paula Alba. I love about John, his style, the way he teaches, he makes me feel comfortable. I heard about him through backstage, which he was one of the best acting coaches out there. I saw an article about him, so I decided to check out his class.
My name is Jeff Haversluck. I've known John for about a year now, and what I like about John is he's kind of like a kung fu teacher in that he gets you into that right mindset, in the zone, like a Zen master. And once you're in that zone in your scene, it's really nothing you can do to mess up.
You want to know what I feel like when I see a beggar on the street?
Hi, I'm Tierney Galligan. I've been with John for about a year now. He just has a very unique teaching style. He has the ability to bring out something very personal.
How's it going? My name is Joe Passarella. I've been with John for probably about 10 months, 11 months or so. And there's really not much to say about the guy. You know, he's the best, you know, and if you're really serious about your craft and you're really serious about, you know, becoming a better actor, he's definitely the guy to go with. That's for sure.
I always heard that John's the best, and he really is. I've been here off and on a couple months, actually more than that, I think. And I love his class. And
hi, I'm Katia Reed, and I've been studying here with Mr. John Pallotta for a few months. I have to say that he is truly amazing, and he nurtures every actor to the core.
Come on, what's his name?
Thank you.
Does your husband know?
Don't let her out. No, come on, twice. Everyone, pound her.
Does he know?
Everybody, come on, pound her.
Everybody wants to know. Who is he? What's his name? Come on, fess up. Why did he find out? Let's hear it.
Apparently.
Hi, my name is Rebecca Young, and I've been with John since January. He teaches ballistics, reverse seduction, every different type of techniques that are very different and very great for cinematography. He's a great director, he's a great teacher, and every time I'm with him, every class that I'm with him for, he just goes to a whole nother dimension and gives me deeper levels to think about.
This isn't in the way, is it?
When he woke me up in the middle of the night, I thought he wanted me. Do you have any idea what it's like to be woken up from a sound sleep with no eyelashes and a dry mouth and have your husband say he's getting it? I thought he wanted me. Do you have any idea what it's like to wake up from a sleep with no eyelashes and a dry mouth and tell you that he's getting it from a woman you're not allowed to have lunch with?
No, something like that. I should check him out. You know, the casting director will give an adjustment and the actor will deliver it the same exact way. And they're not going to know why the casting director has no interest in them, because they've delivered it the same exact way, which the actor won't change. As actors, they just won't change for anything. You know, you delivered a totally 180-degree, 360-degree difference. They want to know that you're going to change on a drop of a dime.
They would tell me, which you basically, you have to do all the homework. You really have to go in and do a lot of work to work on that character in your backstory. Mm-hmm. And the type of thing you have to get behind yourself in that backstory, how deep does that go?
You know, you as a man, you ask yourself questions. You question, you're married. You ask yourself questions. You're constantly asking yourself questions every day. There's life questions you ask yourself in a relationship, in life. You have to ask your character those questions too. So I wrote this play called Jane Hub, and it was read at various places. But when I was doing the play, the play itself was only 50 pages. The homework on the character stories, the development of the characters was literally 500 pages. Sometimes the development of the characters is longer than the play. But the thing is, for believability for the characters, you know, that's what it takes. I mean, sitting up there sometimes I see actors just getting up there and saying words. But as a teacher, I'm trained to dig deep to get the story, create the story. I'm trained to develop characters. I want them to give life. You have a life, right? If you had to tell the story of your life, it would be a book. You have
a little
life.
Book.
No, you have a life. You have a life. If you have a life, right? You have a life. You have a life. You have to give your character that same life. Just like you wake up, you go to work, you buy cameras, you drive a car. Your character has to have that same life.
So let me paint you a picture and you tell me how close I am to this. Let's suppose that I was going up for a role in any one of the police stories that were on TV.
Okay.
And let's say I was going to be a uniformed policeman. Now, in the world of advertising where I come from, I would probably go to the police precinct, I would probably get permission to ride in their car. I would probably stick around the jail cell. I would probably sit there for hours watching people come in, watching phone calls be answered, see the boredom on the policeman's face when they answer the phone, and things like that. And I probably would do that for a good 4 or 5, maybe 6 days, depending on how deep my character was going to be. Well, what would you do?
What I would do is, you know, the way I see it is, make it more interesting for most of those folks, is I watch people. You could do the same story watching a police officer. I live right by a police precinct right down in the village. You know, I was fortunate enough to know that.
Hi, I'm Anastasia, and what I love most about John is he is very passionate teacher. He not just know what he is doing, he know you better than you know even yourself.
Hi there, I'm Jeffrey J. Scott. What's there to say about John Pallotta? I've been with him for about a year now, and I've learned a lot, and I've come a long way since I first started a couple of years ago.
So I've seen John's classes grow from a little bit of students here in New York to almost across the entire country. I am so proud of him. I call him a friend and a mentor. John, you're terrific.
Hi, my name is Patricia Marie Hibner, and I've known John for about 3 years now. And the first time I performed a monologue for him, you know, I was very like overdramatic and everything. And then he took me aside, you know, whispered things in my ear, and it got deep, and it brought emotions out of me that I didn't know I could bring out in front of a crowd.
And the more and more I studied acting, I realized it's not about acting, it's about the depths of your humanity, how far you're willing to go.
And if you're really serious about your craft and you really want to get somewhere, he's the only choice there is.
John, what makes your school so special?
My students in New York, D.C., Chicago, Boston, and Virginia.
That's a lot of places. You must be a real premier acting teacher.
I love what I do. And I love my people.
And he loves his people.
It's a journey.